Hare Krishna. We are inflammable, not incorrigible. We need caution, not condemnation. We all try to improve ourselves, maybe give up our lower desires, but somehow we may keep succumbing to them again and again. And when we succumb repeatedly, we may start thinking that maybe I'm incorrigible, that maybe this is just the way I am. I can't change. I am forever going to live in illusion. No, we are not incorrigible. We are not irreformable. Actually, our situation is that we are inflammable. Inflammable means the fire of desire can easily light in our consciousness and set our consciousness afire. So suppose some material is inflammable and it catches fire very quickly. Then we can't blame the firefighters or the security or the people in that building if the fire comes repeatedly, especially if there are sparks flying around in the environment. Then it's just natural and understandable that the building will catch fire. Although of course it's not desirable, it can be catastrophic, but still it is not a character flaw on the part of the protectors of the building if the building itself is inflammable. So what do we do? So similar is our situation, because all around us the sparks of sensual temptation are flying through the physical culture around us and through the digital culture, which is also all around us. So many sensual images and stimuli are like sparks that keep flying toward our consciousness. And because our consciousness is inflammable, it can catch fire at any time. And once it catches fire, then our morality, our spirituality, our good intentions all get burned down. That's how we relapse. So we need, if an area is inflammable, condemning the guards is not useful. We need caution. They need to be more and more cautious. And even if some other guard comes up, ultimately the guard, they have to be cautious. Condemnation is not the solution, caution is. So that means that we need to remember that we are inflammable and be vigilant in guarding ourselves against the sparks of temptation. So the Bhagavad Gita points to our inflammability when it states that sensual desire is like a fire that is insatiable. It says that avritam jnanametena jnanino nityavairina kamarupena kaunteya dushpurenanalena cha. That dushpurenanalena cha, that this burns like a fire which is insatiable, and this is present within us. So the inflammability of our consciousness is pointed to in the next verse, when Krishna says that this sensuality, the impressions of lust, are situated within our own consciousness. Indriyani mano buddhir asyadishtanam uchyate etair vimohayatyesha jnanamavrutyadehinam. So 3.40, it says that our senses, our mind and intelligence, they are made of inflammable material. And that's why the fire of desire can burn us so easily. And what does Krishna say? The solution, not that we abandon ourselves as incorrigible, but caution. Tasmattam indriyanyadav niyamya bharatarshabha papamanam prajahiya enam jnana vijnana nashanam. So this caution has two parts, that is sensual regulation, that we try as much as possible to not let the sparks of sensual stimuli enter through our senses into our consciousness. We try to fight off the sparks. And the second solution is, Krishna says, spiritual dedication. That is last verse of that chapter, 3.43. Evam buddhe param buddhva samsthabhyatmanam atmana jai shatrum mahabaho kamarupam durasadam says, with our intelligence, we situate ourselves on the spiritual platform. And when we become spiritually connected with the all-attractive source of all pleasure, Krishna, then we will get inner satisfaction. And that said, sublime spiritual satisfaction will decrease our inflammability. And that's how we will be best protected. Thank you. Hare Krishna.